this universe, not apart, goes the universal law. To impart, implant and ingrain moral and cultural values in young boys and girls, PSBB, in association with IMCT Foundation, has organized the program Sustain Environment. In this, we revere Mother Earth, Bhumi Vandanam, as a symbol of environment and Ganga Vandanam as a symbol of water. Nature is one of the best, precious and noblest gifts of God on this planet. Nature is excellent in performing its duty. It is because nature ceaselessly performs its duty that the world is able to derive so many sacred benefits. So, it is our duty and responsibility to nurture nature. We must learn to place a ceiling on our desires such that we limit our use of natural resources. We should remain aware of the impact our actions may have far from our sight and avoid harming the Earth's atmosphere and climate by reducing energy use and our carbon footprint. When we follow right action, we experience the joy of knowing we are helping, not harming Mother Earth. Our lives become more free and fruitful. We should learn to live with a sense of justice, knowing that all beings, including animals and plants, and our future generations depend on nature and that we have to conserve it. The cutting of trees, burning of fossil fuels, the contamination of land, water and environment has badly disturbed the ecosystem of our life. As we all know, water is life's matter and matrix, mother and medium. There is no life without water. We need to safeguard this blessed treasure. The conservation of nature is very important for our future generations. The preservation of nature is a collective issue of humanity. So let's live in harmony with the environment and live in peace.
Nature is the greatest gift from God. We need to preserve Mother Earth and water. Water is the elixir of life. Plants, animals and human beings need water to live.
Let us worship Bhumi Mata and Ganga Mata to give us food and water.
Namaha. Nature is a beautiful creation of God. A person is happy and happy only if he is in the shadow of nature.
The surrounding we live in, the food we eat, the water we drink, the air we breathe, in all our parts of nature.
Life is clean if water is clean. No water, no life.
Bhuvasvaha tatsarviturvaneyam Bhargo devasya dhimahi
The food, the land resources is important because humans not only live but also perform economic activities.
95% of our basic needs and requirements like food, clothing, shelter are obtained from land. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gange Chayamune Chaiva Godavari Saraswati Nadmadi Sindhu Kaveri Jalismin Sannidham Kur.
भगवति गंगे त्रिभुवन तारिणी तरल तरंगे शंकर मौली विहारिणी विमले मम मदिरास्ताम तव पद कमले भागीरथि सुखदायिनी.
Worshipping Mother Nature, the earth, plants and rivers has been our culture from ages. Can we imagine a world without nature? Trees with beautiful rain, pretty flowers and everything else natural. Nature will always be a part of our life. It's up to us to make the environment clean and safe for our future generations.
We are doing a puja for Mother Earth and water. Kriya is showing us the two pots filled with sand and water which symbolize earth and rivers.
We should take care of Mother Earth and water. We should use them sparingly and we should not pollute them.
Prakriti Vandanam, it is our responsibility to save our Mother Nature.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, welcome to Prakriti Vandanam. Samskara, the word samskara is a goal to make an individual perfect. It is key to solve various problems of life. Two samskaras are most important. One is social conduct and the other one is education, Vidya.
Thank you.
everywhere, everything is provided by nature. All living things need water to live. We should stop polluting rivers and land to keep our environment green and clean. I'm happy to take part in Prakriti Vandanam to show the importance of nature.
Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Gange Tribhuvana Tarini Tarala Tarange Shankara Mauli Viharini Vimale Mama Mati Rastam Tava Pada Kamale. Ganga Puja celebrated on the day when Ganga came to earth and Ganga water is holy because it cleans our sins.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. My name is Kritika Prakash from class 5B and I am here to perform Prakriti Vandanam. Shuklam Paradaram Vishnu Shashivarnam Chaturbhujam Prasanna Vadanam Dhyaye Sarva Vignopashantaye Gangesa Yamunesa Godavari Narmadai Sindhu Kaveri Vaigai Tamira Bharani Jalesmin Janitum. Gangaya Namaha, Yamunaya Namaha, Godavariye Namaha, Narmadaye Namaha, Sindhujaye Namaha, Kaveriye Namaha, Vaigaye Namaha, Tamirabharaniye Namaha. We worship the Panchabhutam, all five elements of nature, to form Prakriti. The five elements of nature are air, water, earth, fire and space. The soil represents Mother Earth, the water represents Ma Ganga, and the fire in the Aarti represents Agni. When we do this puja, we worship Prakriti. Thank you.
Yeah, okay.
In Udupi, Ganga Puja is celebrated on the eve of Deepavali. Gange cha Yamune chaiva Godavari Saraswati Narmade Sindhu Kaveri Jalesmin Sannidhim Kuru. Krishna Krishna Rama Rama Govinda Govinda.
Om Bhur Bhavatvah Asya Vichurvare Ajnam Devasya Dhimahi Dijo Jona Prachodaya Om Bhur Bhavatvah Asya Vichurvare Ajnam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Dijo Jona Prachodaya Om Bhur Bhavatvah Asya Vichurvare Ajnam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodayat Shantakaram Bhujagashayanam Padmanabham Suresham Vishwadaram Gaganasadrasham Megavarnam Shubhangam Lakshmikantam Kamalanayanam Yogi Vidyanavandyam Vande Vishnam Gopayaharam Sarvalokaikanatham कल्याणाद्भुत गात्राय कामितार्थ प्रदायिने श्रीमद्वेंकटनाथाय श्रीनिवासाय ते नमः। पूजाय राघवेन्द्राय सत्यधर्मरताय च भजतां कल्पवृक्षाय नमतां कामधेनवे श्री श्री राघवेन्द्राय नमः। श्री श्री राघवेन्द्राय नमः। श्री श्री गुरु राघवेन्द्राय नमः।
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। Environment cannot be sustained unless humans revere the five natural elements. Unless the environment is pure, humans will extinguish. So now I am going to do a puja for Mother Earth and Ma Ganga.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Festivals develop a strong relationship with nature. We worship nature, rivers and bhumi, and maintain ecological balance. If any one of them is harmed, it affects to a number of catastrophes. So it is our duty to preserve and worship them.
Gange cha Yamune chaiva Godavari Saraswati Narmada Sindhu Kaveri Nareesvin Sannidhim Kuru.
Water is one amongst the most important elements. It is addressed as part of the nature and environment. Water is used in religious sacrifices, bathing, washing, drinking, and rituals. It represents different things as knowledge, life, salvation, and time. Water in Hinduism holds a sacred place as it is believed to hold purifying and cleansing powers. It recognizes that water is a part of our life that we are made up of. We should live, breathe, and consume water. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Mahaganga is a holy river originating from Lord Shiva's head. She purifies the heart and soul of every human being. Earth is referred to as our mother and Bhuma Devi, as she protects and takes care of us. Hence, it becomes our duty to respect, worship and protect Mother Earth and all the rivers.
नर्मदे सिंधु कावेरी जलेस्मिन् सन्निधिं कुरु।
श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। The Upanishad says, Ishavasyam idam sarvam. Everything animate or inanimate within the universe is pervaded by God. God has provided us with abundance, but these resources are not the wealth of any one individual. Keeping this view of ancient seers of India, we must take refuge in our culture and honor the age-old tradition of seeing divinity in the elements and worshipping them. Only then can they be preserved.
Nature-human relationship is just like a mother-child relationship. Mother Earth is the source of all creativity and we all depend on her for our growth and meaningful existence. Environment is within us, not outside us. The trees are our lungs, the rivers are our bloodstream. We are all interconnected and what we do to the environment ultimately is like doing it to ourselves. The current deplorable environmental crisis demands a spiritual response, a fundamental reorientation of human consciousness accompanied by action that is born out of inner commitment is very much needed. Thank you.
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. This beautiful planet Earth is our mother and our home. The sacred earth is our ark and all the plants and animals that live in it are our fellow passengers. We must not pollute our land and water resources and so should cherish the world and preserve its beauty and diversity.
Gurubhyo Namaha. Nature is fearless in vastness, bounties and beauties. It is the richest source mankind has. Man can benefit from it, learn from it and enjoy it in countless ways. It is never too late. While one person may not make a big impact on the environment by himself, the collective simple efforts of many concerned people can help conserve nature. Let us all join our hands together to do our share. Thank you.
नमस्ते, मैं सैयद इब्राहिम हारिस गिल आदर्श विद्यालय का छात्र आपके साथ अपना विचार बांटना चाहता हूँ कि हमें इस धरती में रहकर प्रकृति के साथ कैसा व्यवहार करना चाहिए। हमें इस धरती को अपनी माँ के सम्मान मानना चाहिए। कारखानों से हानिकारक धुआं निकलने के कारण उपजाऊ मिट्टी भी दूषित हो रही है। इस हानिकारक मिट्टी में उगने वाली फसल आदि चीज़ों में तरह तरह के रोग पैदा होते हैं। IMCTF अपनी तरफ से पूरी कोशिश कर रही है कि इस धरती को हरा भरा बनाए। हम यह शपथ लेते हैं कि इस धरती का आदर तथा हिफाजत करेंगे, क्योंकि जो हम बोएंगे वही काटेंगे। धन्यवाद।
என் பெயர் ராகேஷ். நான் இல்லாதஷ் பள்ளியில் 8ஆம் வகுப்பு படிக்கிறேன். IMCT கோட்பாடுகள் ஒன்றுடன் ஒன்று தொடர்புடையவை. அவை ஒரு நல்ல வட்டத்தை உருவாக்குகின்றன. நம்முடைய அறிவு நிறைந்த மூதாதையர்கள் நம் வளமான இயற்கையிலும் கலாச்சாரத்திலும் ஒவ்வொரு மனிதனும் பாதுகாக்கும் விதத்தில் அவர்கள் வாழ்க்கையை வடிவமைத்தனர். நம்முடைய அறிவு நிறைந்த மூதாதையர்கள் இயற்கையும் அதன் உயிரினங்களையும் பண்டிகைகளை கொண்டாடும் விதத்தில் வணங்குவதற்கு இதுதான் காரணம். அவர்கள் தாய் பூமி என்று அழைப்பதன் மூலம் அவர்கள் வாழும் பூமியை மதித்து காத்தனர். கங்கை நதி மிகவும் புனிதமானது. அது செல்லும் இடமெல்லாம் புனிதத்தை கொடுக்கிறது. எனவே பஞ்சாப் குழுமத்தின் மாணவர்களாகிய நாங்கள் இங்கு ஒன்றிணைந்து எங்கள் மரியாதையை நிலத்திற்கும் அதில் ஓடுகின்ற நீர்நிலைகளுக்கும் செலுத்துகிறோம். நாம் அனைவரும் மரங்களை நட்டு பூமியை பாதுகாப்போம் என்று உறுதியேற்போம். இதன் மூலம் அடுத்த தலைமுறையினருக்கு பசுமையான பூமியை விட்டு செல்வோம். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
Namaskaram, I am Nityashree. I am studying in 6th year. Today I am going to do Ganga Puja. Gange cha Yamune chaiva Godavari Saraswati Nadmade Sindhu Kaveri Jalesnim Sannidhim Guru Samudra Vasane Devi Parvadarsana Mandale Vishnu Patni Namastubhyam Padasparsham Samastame. Thank you.
கங்கே ச யமுனே சைவ கோதாவரி சரஸ்வதி நர்மதே சிந்து காவேரி ஜலேஸ்மம் சன்னிவம் குரு. சமுத்திர வசனே தேவி பார்வதி சர மண்டலே விஷ்ணு பத்னி நமஸ்துப்யம் பாத சரத கணேஷ்மதி.
समुद्र वसने देवी पर्वतस्तन मंडले विष्णु पत्नी नमस्तुभ्यं पादस्पर्शं समस्वमे.
ॐ गंगे च यमुने चैव गोदावरी सरस्वती नर्मदे सिंधु कावेरी जलस्मिन् सन्निधिं गुरु. समुद्र वसने देवी पर्वतस्तन मंडले विष्णुपत्नी नमस्तुभ्यं पादस्पर्शं समश्वमे.
नमस्कारं श्री वैद्यनाथ अष्टकं श्री राम सौमित्री
I revere motherland as symbol as environment. I revere my parents as symbol of human values. I revere my teacher as symbol of learning. I revere humans as symbol of motherhood. I revere war heroes as symbol of Bharat Mata.
त्रिपथगा दिव्या शीतदोया अशैवला
Mother, 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 mother महेश्वरी भगवती गंगे त्रिभुवन तारिणी तरल तरंगे देवी सुरेश्वरी भगवती गंगे त्रिभुवन तारिणी तरल तरंगे।
वेरी गुड उदय। आई एम जी अखिल कार्तिक फ्रॉम क्लास 2A2। आई एम हियर टू शेयर माय व्यूज अबाउट द वेज टू प्रिजर्व एंड सेव द रिवर गैंजेस। The Ganges is the most important river on earth. It is believed by the Hindus that the Ganges is a goddess who dwells in the crown of Lord Shiva, spreading his blessings to all the people through her divine and pure water. The Ganges was born at the foothills of Himalayas, nourishing the soil along its banks, making India a fertile land. At present, the Ganges is under serious threat from human sewages, toxic wastes, and other chemicals. Our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi ji, as a part of his Swachh Bharat campaign, has launched NMCG, a national mission for our clean Ganga. Its main objectives are improving the water quality of river Ganga, preventing toxic waste and other chemicals from entering the river Ganga, pollution abatement, protection of floodplains, and creating public awareness. Thus, by educating the public and industries about the needs of clean Ganga and punishing the offenders who pollute the river, we can early save and preserve the river Ganges. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Jai Hind.
Jai Gurudev. I am Sriram from Pedu. I am talking about importance of preserve Ganga water. Ganga is a holy river. Ganga has most important to Indians. It is our national river. This is the symbol of socialism. The water of Ganga is believed to miracle properties of purifying soul and healing the bodies. People and animals depending on Ganga river, like drinking and bathing water, cooking, fishing, agricultural, industrial, etc. Ganga river is the most polluted river in our country. This pollution due to dumping city garbage, industrial wastage, agricultural wastage, human and animal excreta, human bodies burning, etc. Our government formed Ganga Cleaning Board. It is taking all steps to clean the river. So dear all, we also help our government cleaning the Ganga river. Thank you.
Jai Gurudev. Mother Earth consists of land, water and air for healthy life. we have to keep clean all this. We call earth as mother and river as goddesses. Ganga river is sacred river. We keep house, temple and clean and school clean. Please keep clean river and live healthy. Jai Hind.
Good day everyone. I am Mrs. Jayanti Rajagopal from PS Senior Secondary School. I am going to talk about Bhumi Mata. Bhumi Mata. So பூமியும் அம்மாவையும் கனெக்ட் பண்ண போகிறேன். அம்மா எப்படி இதெல்லாம் பேஷண்ட்டாக நம்ம பண்ணுற அமக்கலத்துக்கெல்லாம் தாங்கிப்பாளோ அதே மாதிரி தான் பூமி மாதா. ஸோ பூமி மாதா இஸ் தி எம்பாடிமெண்ட் ஆஃப் பேஷன்ஸ். வை டூ ஐ சே தட் ஷீஸ் அன் எம்பாடிமெண்ட் ஆஃப் பேஷன்ஸ்? திஸ் இஸ் பிகாஸ் வி ஆர் ட்ரபிளிங் ஹர் அ லாட். வி கீப் டிகிங் ஹர், டிகிங். வாட் ஃபார் டூ வி டிக் ஹர்? வி ஆர் டிகிங் ஹர் ஃபார் அவர் ஓன் பெனிஃபிட்ஸ், like for ores and minerals, gold, diamond, what not. And then we dig her for construction purposes, we dig her for water, we dig her for road making, we dig her for making dams, we dig her for agriculture. When I say agriculture, we dig her, but what does she give us? She gives us food for everyone. All the living beings are contained only on the Mother Earth. Then without her we won't have water, without her we won't have air to breathe. So our survival is only because of Mother Earth, and we are only torturing her always. But does she feel that we are torturing her? But again, one more question. Whenever we are digging her out, are we filling up the gaps? Definitely not. So the surface is becoming weak and it leads to earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, and we are our own troublemakers. It's high time that we realize that we need to save the earth by not polluting the water, by not polluting the land, by not polluting the air, and planting more trees so that we get more rains and we save the earth. By saving the earth, we are saving ourselves. Thank you.
Namaste. I am Megha from PS Senior Secondary School. Today I am going to talk about the importance of sustaining nature. Respect for life, awareness of nature's forces, and awareness of the various orders of life, plants, trees, animals, forests, are the beliefs embedded in the Hindu perspective of nature. Nature is seen by Hindus as a gift from God to heal the souls. Thus, Hindu temples were built in areas surrounded with rocks and trees with fruits and flowers used to offer in prayers. And now I am going to do a puja for a sacred plant, Tulsi. Tulsi has a great importance in the Hindu culture since it is believed to be an incarnation of Goddess Lakshmi.
If we do not take care of nature, nature will not take care of us. This is something seen increasingly in today's time as people continue to exploit the environment for their profit. This needs to stop. We have to change. The best time for new beginnings is now. Thank you.
Namaste children. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. I take this opportunity to thank the Prithvi Vandana organizers for having permitted me to share a few thoughts with you about the rivers in India. In India, we worship the rivers and other water bodies. Do you know why do we worship the rivers, children? It's just because they have been the cradles of our civilization. We in India celebrate a lot of festivities around the rivers, like the Ganga Arati festival, the Kumbh Mela, and in Tamil Nadu we celebrate the Adi Peruku festival and so on. So here goes the story from the Hindu mythology. In Hindu mythology, the Ganga River was created when Lord Vishnu took an incarnation of a dwarf Brahmin. This dwarf Brahmin took two steps to cross the universe. The second step, when he took, the foot of the Vishnu's big toe had hit the wall of the universe and had created a hole through which the Mandakini River started flowing. Meanwhile, the mythological king Bhagiratha heard that King Sagara's 60,000 ancestors had been incinerated by the sage Kapila. And these people had been, Bhagiratha was concerned that these people had to go to heaven. So he went and asked sage Kapila for a remedy. Sage Kapila told him to pray to Lord Vishnu earnestly. Then Bhagiratha prayed for 1,000 years to Vishnu, and Vishnu was gratified by his prayers. He decided to descend river Ganga to the universe. But if Ganga were to descend from the universe, all of a sudden from the heaven, then she would fall onto the earth with a swirlingness, and she would damage the whole earth all of a sudden. So it was at this time that Lord Shiva accepted to allow her to flow on his hair, in his hair, and slowly let it down to the earth over 1,000 years. Then Bhagiratha took the step of guiding the river Ganga to flow into river India, and river India split into various tributaries, and that is how river Ganga came into India.
Jaya 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 Bharata Janani, Jaya He Jaya He Bangaru Dharani, Jaya 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 Bharata Janani, Jaya He Jaya He Bangaru Dharani, Ganga Krishna Godavari Tungabhadra Tarangalu, Ganga Krishna Godavari Tungabhadra Tarangalu, Nirantaramu Ninnu Koluva Ninadinchunu, Jaga Jagalu Jaya 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 Bharata Janani, Jaya He Jaya He Bangaru Dharani, Syanti Mata Bharata Mata Kavviste Kali Mata, Syanti Mata Bharata Mata Kavviste Kali Mata, Kapadave Mammu Talli, Kapadave Mammu Talli Karunarasa Kalpavalli, Jaya 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 Bharata Janani, Jaya He Jaya He Bangaru Dharani, Jaya 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 Bharata Janani, Jaya He Jaya He Bangaru Dharani, Bangaru Dharani, Bangaru Dharani.
Shri Vaidyanatha Ashtagam, Shri Rama Saumitri Jatayu Vetar.
गंगा प्रवाहित जटाधराय त्रिलोचनाय स्मरकालहंते समस्तते वै रविपूजिताय श्रीवैद्यनाथाय नमः शिवाय भक्तप्रियाय त्रिपुरान्तकाय पिनाकिने दुष्ट हराय नित्यं प्रत्यक्षलीलाय मनुष्यलोके श्रीवैद्यनाथाय नमः शिवाय नन्दि।
I am B. Srigari, studying 5th standard, Sri Sitaram Vidyalaya School. Today I talk about Bhumi Vandanam and Ganga Vandanam. Bhumi Vandanam. From ancient days, Mother Earth or Bhumi Devi is looked upon as goddess. Mother Earth is treated as a living being. It's our duty to do Bhumi Vandanam to her always. In Inca mythology, they refer Earth as Panchama. Panchama refers to Mother Universe. The goddess Panchama is a fertilized goddess who presides over planting and harvesting. Mother Earth referred as from where all living beings life sprang stars. In ancient Vedas, spoiling environment is considered as a sin. So we should protect our environment from pollution and it's our responsibility to save our Earth. Ganga Vandanam. Our Mother Earth recognized into four spheres as lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and the biosphere. In this, hydrosphere referred as the water side. We understand that all living beings depend on water. Water is essential to all forms of life. The Ganga is the largest river in India. Ganga is holy water. Ganga Vandanam is not only to protect Ganga and also all other rivers of India. Thank you.
I am B. Jayashree, studying 7th standard in Sri Sitaram Vidyalaya Matriculation School. Today I am going to share my thoughts about Bhumi Vandanam and Ganga Vandanam. Bhumi Vandanam. Earth is refers to Mother Earth. We worship as the goddess Bhumi Devi. Mother Earth includes rivers, mountains and fertile lands. Spoiling environment is referred to as a sin in ancient Vedas. The Vedic people desire to live a life for 100 years. This wish can be fulfilled only by when environment is unpolluted. They refer Mother Earth as wife of Vishnu Deva. It's clear that the Vedic version is to live in harmony with environment was not necessarily physical but was far wider and much comprehensive. Beautiful verse of Rig Veda is, heaven is my father and brother atmosphere and my navel and the great earth is my mother. Nature lays somewhere between in the center with angels above and demon below her. It's our duty to safeguard our Mother Earth by protecting her from pollution. Thanking you. Ganga Vandanam.
Water is the important natural resource of our life. All living beings depend on water for life. Ganga Devi is the largest river and it's referred as the holy river. It has its own religious importance. The water which comes in the form of river, ocean, ponds and lakes. Concept of ocean as the continuous body of water with relatively interchange among its parts. Water within a river is generally collected from precipitation through the surface. A body of water is said to be a lake when it is in land and it is not a part of ocean. Water plays a vital role in all holy rituals. It's our duty to do Ganga Vandanam by protecting the water resource from pollution. By doing Ganga Vandanam, all the rivers, oceans, ponds, lake will be safeguarded from pollution. Thank you.
Namaste everyone, I am Anniki Shastri. I am studying 6th standard A section. I am studying in Sri Sankara Vidyalaya Matriculation High Secondary School at Oorapakkam. I am taking part in Prakriti Vandanam in IMCT competition. Prakriti can be defined anything that involves energy, in short nature. Vandanam means worship. Prakriti Vandanam means worshipping nature and showing gratitude to Mother Nature. It is also a part of conservation of forest. Forest conservation, that name defines protecting forest and nature. All natural resources are absolutely essential for our world and ecosystem. Let's put our hands together and pray for our world. Let's see some lines about nature. Song name is Idu Namma Bhoomi, Tamil. I'm going to sing the song. That song name is Idu Namma Bhoomi, first 3 lines. And we'll see that song's meaning also.
இயற்கையை அழித்து வாழ்ந்திட நினைப்பது நாயமா, மடியினில் சுமப்பவள் மனதிலே வதைத்தா தாங்குமா. இறைவன் தந்த இந்த இயற்கை உந்தன் நெஞ்சம் மறந்ததே. இயற்கையை அழித்து வாழ்ந்திட நினைப்பது நாயமா, மடியினில் சுமப்பவள் மனதிலே வதைத்தா தாங்குமா. இறைவன் தந்த இந்த இயற்கை உந்தன் நெஞ்சம் மறந்ததே.
Now we can see this song's few lines meaning. First line meaning, destroying nature is good. No, it's not good. That means you are troubling the nature. Second line meaning, mother produced us. That mother itself we are giving trouble. Is she will take the pain? No, we should not give trouble to our mother. Mean mother nature. Third line meaning, God gives us nature but we forgotten God and we are destroying nature and giving trouble to our nature. That is also not good. So we should give respect to our God and mother nature. Save nature and save lives. Jai Hind.
Namaste to all. My name is S. Jotsana. I am studying in 3rd standard C section. My school name is Sri Shankara Vidyalaya Matriculation Higher Secondary School, located in Oorapakkam, Chennai.
My name is S. Samhita. I am studying in 2nd standard D section. My school name is Sri Shankara Vidyalaya Matriculation Higher Secondary School, located in Oorapakkam, Chennai.
Now we are going to perform the Bhoomi Puja.
Samudravasane Devi Parvadasana Mandite Vishnu Patni Namastubhyam Padasparishan Samakshvame.
The meaning of the sloka is, it say, Mother Earth, you are with rivers and mountains on you. Salutations to the wife of Vishnu Deva. Forgive me for keeping me feet on you. Mm-hmm.
நன்றி, வணக்கம்.